Guys, Michelle Glass here, and our topic for this presentation are the cranial nerves. There are 12 pair of cranial nerves, so of course that means you have two of each, a left and a right. Now, each of these cranial nerves has been assigned both a name and a number. The number is always given in Roman numerals, so make sure you practice that. Remember, your V stands for 5, so IV stands for 4, and then VI is 6. And so on. And then your X represents 10, IX is 9, XI is 11, XII is 12. So part of what you have to learn is the name and the number of the cranial nerve. The other piece of information is the type of cranial nerve, meaning what kind of information is being transmitted. So it can be either a sensory nerve, it can be a motor nerve, or it can be both sensory and motor. Okay, let's get started. So we are looking here at the underneath side of our frontal lobe, and we have our cranial nerve number 1, which is our olfactory nerve. And next we have our optic nerve, which is cranial nerve number 2. Now the olfactory nerve and the optic nerve are both sensory nerves. Okay, let's do a dissection real quick. And we're going to be looking at where the midbrain meets the pons on the front side. Pituitary gland is a little bit in our way, but here we can see our cranial nerve number 3, oculomotor. Oculomotor, as the name implies, is a motor nerve. Okay, let's take a look at the back side of our midbrain. You have the 4 bodies on the back that we call the Kapur quadrigemini. Underneath the 4 bodies going across the midbrain, you have the cranial nerve number 4. This is our trochlear nerve. That one is also motor. Looking at the front of the midbrain, you have on the top lateral side, cranial nerve number 5. Trigeminal. This is both. Then what I like to do is look at where my pons meets my medulla, and I find 6, 7, and 8. 6, 7, and 8. Cranial nerve 6 is the abducens. That's a motor. Cranial nerve 7 is the facial. That's a both. And then cranial nerve 8 can be called either vestibulocochlear or auditory nerve, which might be easier for you starting out. The auditory nerve is sensory nerve. Okay, then going down the medulla oblongata, we have, let me see, 9, 10, and 11. So 9, 10, and 11. Cranial nerve 9, that little piece right there, you see it? That is my glossopharyngeal, which is both. Cranial nerve 10 is my vagus, which is both. And then cranial nerve 11 can be called either spinal accessory or accessory spinal. So it's actually going on the medulla oblongata and extending down to the spinal cord. So this is number 11, if I forgot to say, and it is motor. And then finally, I have 12 here and here. 12 is my hypoglossal. My hypoglossal is motor. Okay, so I am going to take just this part of my model and stick my brainstem piece in there. And then I'm gonna do quick run through if I can. So I have cranial nerve 1, olfactory, sensory, cranial 2, cranial nerve 2, optic, sensory. And then I'll open that one up to show you 3, oculomotor, motor, and then I'll just take that piece out, fell everywhere, okay, and go to the back of my midbrain, 4, 4, trochlear, motor, 5, trigeminal, both, 6, abducens, motor, 7, facial, both, 8, vestibulocochlear or auditory sensory, 9, glossopharyngeal, both, 10, vagus, both, 11, accessory spinal, spinal accessory motor. Let's eat on both sides. And then 12, hypoglossal motor. Down here, in case you're curious, these are spinal nerves, so we're not labeling those here. Okay, that's it.